about class or maybe the whole form?
Of my first impression of the class, the VA class?
Or maybe the whole form, or us in general, the form sixes.
Okay, so my first impression of the whole 2016 Form 6 for me has been a very good one, because I've actually known most of the students from Form 1 or if not Form 2, because I've been here since 2010. So it's been the first time for me to see a whole, almost an entire cohort come through and see people going from being Form 1s, which is pretty hard to even remember now, through to being Form 6s. And I was really pleased to see so many students that I'd taught in VA coming through and doing VA and diploma as well. It was really nice to see that continuity.
Well, my first impressions of the whole form in general is that we get to see how all of us have grown, and I see people come and go. And it's really interesting to see that people have developed in either even their artworks or even in school academics as well. And I just am surprised at how much could change in just 4 years of time, since I was just here in Form 3. Mm. So, yeah.
What was the most memorable event for you, maybe in these 6 years or these 4 years? It's probably going to be yesterday, but what was your most memorable event?
Okay. So, the most memorable event for me over my last 6 years of being here is always something to do with the art exhibition. Mm. And every year, it's always an absolute revelation for me, whether it's a diploma exhibition or whether it's an off-site exhibition like at the Jockey Club, to see all the students' work come together and to actually find out things, even though I'm supposedly been your art teacher or your art teacher, that I suddenly discover new things about you as individuals and as people in this process of bringing the exhibition together. Because as you know, in the VA room, we don't get to put up all the work.
Yeah.
I don't get to see all of it at once. You don't get to see all of it at once. And often there are things that I've not picked up on or that I've not realized were connected, or just how important they were personally or as part of your journey as VA students. And then I'm reading the text or I'm looking at the work and I go, oh yeah, okay, I get that now. Okay. It's really interesting. I love the fact that I get to see you as people in a outside of the classroom.
Mm. Well, for me, the most memorable event was yesterday, since it was the end of our VA as a whole in the course of 2 years. And it's really interesting how we have integrated some of the works outside of VA, like economics, politics, even language itself, and how they all show artistic elements. And we get to see a development over the course of time and chronologically through our artworks as well. And it was a very fun day to do, and we get to explain all our works to other people, other teachers as well, and like how even like IB course, the IB courses that we do like contribute to our artworks as well.
Yeah. But we don't. So not every school takes this approach. Some schools very just taught by modules and taught by units, and they get all the assessment material they need, but it's a very controlled way of doing it. Our way is quite chaotic and fairly messy in terms of we just start you guys off and then keep asking you questions. And we just basically really rely on the fact that everyone has a personal thread. Everyone has their own authentic way of looking at the world, and that's what we have to try to foster and encourage. We have to try to find that, try to identify that and find that out by a kind of interrogation, really, a process of interrogation. Yeah, go for it.
What is the school to you, apart from your school, but your workplace?
What is the school to me?
Is that anything more than just a school?
Well, okay, to me, the idea of school and working in a school has become a very different thing. As I've worked here for longer and changed roles, VA teacher, TOK teacher, working as the deputy head of upper school, my understanding of what a school is, from my point of view, has changed. To me now, it's much more of a learning place than it was before. When I first came here, I came as a teacher. Now I don't see myself quite in the same way. I find that I'm much more in a position of learning how to be a teacher, and that every student is a kind of way of me learning how to teach this curriculum, how to teach art. There's a lot of stuff that says you can't art something that can't be taught. So I'm always facing that idea of, well, if that's the case, then how do we teach art, and what does it mean to teach art? So I'm always having to ask myself questions like that. But also learning about the lives of people who are almost 40 years younger than me, who are living in a very different age, and learning about the dynamics of a society that's very different from mine, and how do you guys face the future? The future I faced when I was your age was a very different future. It's still the future, but the way we thought of it is very different. So I see myself in quite a different position now. I used to think, okay, I'm really good at what I do, I'm a teacher, I'm here to teach them, and I don't really feel like that quite so much anymore. It's good. It makes me feel much more alive, much more connected, much more engaged. And it provokes me to want to learn things. So yeah. I feel more like, for myself, doing things that I like doing, like making art, which is one thing that I'm starting to come back to. And that's from you guys.
Yeah. Well, it all eventually goes back to the school's vision for this year. Like, look back, move forward.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a process of development. And we all see it, even in our exhibitions. Like, we see how we have moved over the course of time. And we have changed, yes, like as you have said. And I used to think that TOK was a boring subject until I found out that it was very interesting, and how everything is going to be in place and integrated so well that there's all connections in between them. And yeah, I've seen school as a place to learn, a place to develop our skills, and yeah.
I think in terms of things that really affected me personally, one is just getting some feedback from students when you realize that you've actually made a difference, or because teaching's a very intangible thing. It's not as though we're making tins of baked beans and at the end of the day you can see that you've got 20 tins of baked beans. It's a relationship. So it's very intangible. I can't see the outcomes. And it's a slow process as well. You know, the process of learning to be a teacher, the process of students learning, it's a very slow process.
Yes.
And to get feedback when someone actually says, when you did that, That really helped me.
Yeah.
And you go, oh, okay, well, I wouldn't have known. So that those are really important things. I think when you realize that students trust you with a big issue in their life, or when they come to you for some support and you realize that you've built up a trustworthy relationship, those are very touching things, because often teachers can be just really focused on preparing the work, delivering the work, marking the work, and not realize that we play a kind of almost symbolic role in the lives of the students. But when that sort of separation breaks down, and you realize there are friendships here, actually there's trust, there's more than just that idea of it's about, you know, academic achievement, but we actually do have a community. Those things I think are really important and memorable.
I have to think about it.
It's a tricky one, isn't
it? Yeah. Touching, right? Touching.
Memorable.
One more thing that I think for me is really memorable as an art teacher or as a TOK teacher, when I see that from my point of view, that a student's kind of got it, that they've kind of breached that threshold of incomprehension. TOK would be a good example, where I just feel like I'm pulling their teeth out and they don't seem to be enjoying this. And then there is a point where some threshold gets breached and the eyes light up and the student can suddenly do things with ease or with more facility and consequently with enthusiasm. And as a teacher, you think, oh, well, all of that, what seemed to be experimental, I tried it like this, and then you see that shift, and that's a really important moment, because you know that you're doing something right. You may not know exactly what it was, but you know you're doing something right, and you know that someone's moved on, and you can see, oh, you know, these gains are being made.
Well, a touching moment for me could be seeing people come and go, and it's just that I know they're off to a better place, and like they went on and moved forward with a life, like going to other schools overseas and doing like new opportunities, and like sometimes we feel envious, but we know that they're developing and that they are also moving forward, I guess, yeah.
It's probably almost break time. I'll just chip in one more thing which you can edit in or out. Another really, I think I find really important about the school, and I think is really touching, is last night at the opening, the number of ex-students who are here, who are ex-students from 2 or 3 years ago, who've turned up to the show and who are looking around and who are asking questions, and they can remember, oh, they were, you know, when I was in Form 5, they were a Form 3, and they're coming back and looking at the development of their almost like younger siblings coming through the same process. And I think that's a really unique thing, is because we had people who were in Form 4 who've now moved overseas, came back to see the drama performance and the art show. There were kids who left at Form 5 who are now studying in Europe, came back. Kids who left last year who are now studying university. I think that's, you sort of realize there is something really, there is a real bond here, and a real sense of
a community.
A community, yeah.
The last question. So you both talk about the same thing. What are your hopes for the future, or how do you see us as a Form 6 in the future?
You can do that one first.
Well, I hope for all the Form 6s out there who are, and also the future students who will graduate soon, and I hope that they will have the best in what they do, and that they will achieve and continue to develop in learning and also in life. And and to see each of them grow, and then looking back at the past as a constant reminder of how where you were, and where you and then looking at the present where you are now, is just to remind yourself that you have moved on with life. And yeah.
My hopes for this this year's Form 6, collectively and for each individual, my hopes are that we have, as a school, the entire school, not just the teaching staff or the support staff, but the entire student body, that have prepared you guys well to move out of this. It is a kind of rite of passage, graduation, and moving out of school into a much sort of broader relationship with the world, a more complex one. You're going to have to make decisions on your own. You'll still have the support of your family. You can still contact people here if you need advice, but you are getting into a position where you're going to have to make decisions for yourselves about your own futures. And I hope that we've equipped you with the abilities to do that. Independence, integrity, a sense of responsibility, a sense of courage. I really hope that you've acquired those, and that when you need them, you can draw on them, because that's really what you guys need in the future. It's not your grades so much. You can't sort of go, "Where's my six?" or "Where's my five?" But it's those personal qualities, and if you've encountered that and started to realize the importance of that, those individual personal qualities, and how far that will take you in life. That's what I hope that we've done, and that's what I hope for you guys, because that's how you'll grow as people.